Welcome to dbForge Studio for Oracle Tutorials. In this video, we're going to review and compare two mighty database development tools, Oracle SQL Developer and dbForge Studio. Let's start with the former. Oracle SQL Developer does not require installation. Just download its archive from the official Oracle website, unzip it in the desired folder, and run the program. In order to create a new connection to the server, you need to enter the connection name, username, and password. Keep in mind that the user must be created on the server and have the necessary permissions to work with the database. In order not to enter a password each time you are connecting to the server, select the Save Password checkbox. In the Details section, you need to enter the host name and the port number, as well as provide the SID or service name. On the left pane, you can see a list of all database objects on the server. If there are multiple schemas on the server, you can filter the list to be able to work with the required objects only. To start writing and running SQL queries, press Ctrl+N, go to Database Files, select SQL File, and click OK. Next, enter a file name, select a directory to save the new SQL script to, and click OK again. In order not to qualify database objects with a schema name again and again throughout the entire query, you need to set the current schema. As you can see, the hint algorithm does not understand that the schema is already set and suggests a table name with the schema qualifier. Oops, this hint didn't work, and we'll have to write everything without hints. Let's now look at dbForge Studio for Oracle. To open a new SQL document, we press Ctrl+N. The Studio's advanced code completion offers relevant hints and automatically creates all the possible table joins. Even if you're a beginner in SQL, it's not a reason to keep away from complex queries. With Query Builder, you can build queries visually without any coding. Just drag the necessary tables onto the diagram and create relationships between them, if there are any. Next, select the checkboxes for the fields you want to query. dbForge Studio for Oracle builds relationships between tables automatically. You just need to select the required fields and run the script. If you right-click a database object in Object Explorer of Oracle SQL Developer, the Object Context menu will appear, showing the operations you can perform on this object. For instance, from the Table Context menu, you can modify your table, import data into it, add, remove, and rename its columns, add constraints and indexes, add or edit privileges, and so on. If you click an object in Object Explorer, its editor will open. As you can see, the table editor has a bunch of tabs, each responsible for certain functionality. If you go to the Model tab, you will see the tables that our table has relationships with. When you switch to the Dependencies tab, you will see all the objects that refer to this table. In dbForge Studio for Oracle, you can create a database diagram and define relationships between tables. You can zoom the diagram in and take a closer look at it. The foreign keys that create links between the tables are marked with white icons, from which arrows go to the corresponding primary keys. Every organization has its own coding standards, code structure, indentation, in other words, a SQL formatting standard. Standardized code formatting results in better code readability and helps you examine legacy code fast. For this, Oracle SQL Developer has the format feature. In Preferences, you can adjust code formatting to your requirements. To format your script in dbForge Studio for Oracle, just use the keyboard shortcut. This tool boasts advanced formatting options that allow you to easily customize the formatting settings. The Studio offers a collection of different formatting profiles, which facilitates adherence to the standards of different projects and makes the process more flexible. To write more accurate queries faster, you can use code snippets. To edit snippet templates in Oracle SQL Developer, go to Preferences and then click Code Templates. You can modify both the code template itself and the short name that is used to quickly insert your template into code. Let's try this. We go to the code editor and enter, for example, CF, then we select Hint. The corresponding code template gets inserted. Let's try again with the CP short name. Voila! The procedure creation template is inserted. In dbForge Studio for Oracle, you can open the Snippets Manager either from the Tools menu or with a shortcut. In the Snippets Manager, you can customize code templates and snippet short names. For easier navigation, templates can be divided into directories. You can insert a snippet by dragging it from the Snippets Manager onto the code editor or by entering the required short name and then pressing Tab. A PL SQL debugger is a must for every professional developer. To debug a procedure in Oracle SQL Developer, you need to right-click the procedure and compile it for debugging. After that, set the breakpoints and click Debug. Now you can move through the procedure step by step. While debugging, you can see the values of variables by hovering over them. The debugger that comes with dbForge Studio for Oracle is quite similar to the one in Oracle SQL Developer. You also need to compile the procedure, add breakpoints, and start debugging. Here, you can add variables to the watch list and observe how the values change in real time. That's it for now. And if you want to try it all yourself, download a free 30-day trial of dbForge Studio for Oracle and familiarize yourself with the extensive functionality it offers.